So now we'll talk about the market structure. Why we need to discuss about the market structure? Why you need to know the market structure? Because think of the production process. You have to use the inputs, so you have the costs. Okay, you have the costs, and you need to know about the revenue. Revenue is what? You have the quantity, and you have to multiply it by the price, so you will get the revenue. This is your revenue, this is your quantity, this is price. So up to now we learned about the costs, and then we learn if you put these inputs, what output will get. Because if you don't, because when we decide to produce something, it is a kind of X and T situation. X and T means you are just planning. It is in the planning stage, whether I will go to produce it or not. If I produce, how far I will go. Okay, because when you plan to produce something, you need to know the costs. So it is very easy for you to know. And then what you need to know? You need to know the revenue. To know about the revenue, you need to know what?
How much?
Yeah, how much the output you will get by using these inputs. Okay, then what will be the price? Then you just multiply quantity by?
Price.
This price is not actually, it's a kind of estimated price. So it is kind of prospective price. You don't know what the price exactly will be if it is not ordered. If sometimes you get to the advance order, that's okay, you know the price. But if you don't have any advance order,
expected
you have to take it to the market. So then you don't know. So you are expecting, you just estimate the price. So this is the estimated price. And also the quantity. How will you know the quantity? Production technology will tell you. If you put this input, what output you will get. So that's why production technology is very crucial. Without production technology, you cannot know about this output. If you don't have the uncertainty, risk, so these are the other things. But if everything is normal, you will get this output. Okay? So if you know the output, for example, is 10, and price, for example, 100, so your revenue will be 1,000. So how you will know the price?
From market.
We knew the cost, we knew the output, we get the output from the inputs, which the production technology we use to know that. So we covered it. And now we need to know the price. How will you know the price?
From the market.
You have to know the market structure where your product will be exchanged. So that is the very important thing. So that's why market structure is important. For example, if your product, you are the only seller in the market, then you can decide the price. You can make the price. Because you are the only seller, so there is no competition. So you can make the price. You can ask 100, 150, 200, doesn't matter. Yes, so then the buyers, it depends on them, how much they will buy. You cannot decide two together. You can decide price as well as the quantity. You can decide two. You can decide one. So you can say, okay, I will sell my product at 200. So maybe five people will buy, fine. And then if you decide, okay, I will sell my product at 50 taka. So maybe 500 people will buy. It doesn't matter. So it depends on my desire. So I like to have a high price or low price. Or I like to have more revenue or lower amount of revenue. If I ask higher price, I will not be able to sell that much commodity. So maybe the revenue will be. So it depends on again on the quantity. If I ask higher price, if the product is an essential product, then it's good. People are bound to buy it. But I mean inelastic product. If the product is elastic one, then if you decide a high price or ask higher price, your revenue will fall. We know there is a relationship between revenue and the elasticity. So that's why it is important to know the market structure. So if you have the only one producer or seller, so you have one control. You have the full control over the price. But if you have to compete with a lot of other sellers, then you may not have the control. You may not make the price. You have to take the price. Whatever the price is established in the market, you have to take it. So that's why market structure is important. Otherwise, you will not be able to estimate it. You will be difficult. So let us talk about the market structure. What does it mean? So, first of all, we have to understand what is market. What is market? What is market? Yeah, we said we have the buyers, sellers, and a commodity.
Interaction.
There should be interaction. Yes, so the interaction among the buyers and sellers centered around the commodity. So that is what market. So the interaction, the process of interaction among the buyers and sellers is called market. So it can be a place, you may not have a place, it doesn't matter. You can just talk to the sellers over phone. You can just email them. It can be asynchronous.
Yeah, it can be virtual.
Yes, it can be asynchronous. It can be synchronous. So you can come to a place, you can talk, you can go for video conferencing, you can Skype or any other technology you can use. Or you can just send a mail. It's kind of asynchronous. You send a mail, the buyer or seller will respond later on. It's an asynchronous communication. So this kind of interaction may happen. Maybe a totally real-time interaction. That means I will call you, you are just talking to me. It's a real-time interaction. Or it can be asynchronous. That means I just dropped a message for you. So you will check it and you will respond.
It is virtual.
Yeah. So virtual or physical, doesn't matter. You can just write a letter and post it and it will go to that person and he will respond. So previously it happened. Now we have the technology so we can go for the virtual interaction. So this interaction can be of anything, anytime. It can be place-based, it can be virtual, it can be anything. Doesn't matter. But if the buyers and sellers interact on centered on a commodity, that is called market. So if you like to understand the market structure, whatever you like to understand, you must understand the components. If you like to understand about a disease, what you have to know? What kind of virus or bacteria that is, and you have to split it in different portions. So all the components you have to understand. Otherwise you will not be able to understand it fully or perfectly. So that's why if you like to understand the market structure, you have to understand the components of the market. These are the three components. One is buyer, seller, and the commodity. So nature of the commodity matters here. The behavior of the buyers, number of the buyers matters. Number of the sellers matters. Okay, so because these things will decide what will be the structure of the market, what will be the shape of the interaction. Structure of the interpretation. Who will dominate the market? Who will be the follower? So these are the things actually we have to consider when we talk about the market structure. So let us try to say the number of buyers. Number of buyers. This is a kind of ideal situation. Just we are just considering a number of buyers here, then number of sellers, and think of the nature of the commodity. What type of the nature of the commodity? So the commodity we are talking about is important. The nature. What type of commodity it is? For example, if I sell a soap, for example, Lux. I am producer of Lux, and you are producer of Kea soap. These two things are not same. These are similar but not same. These are not identical. So if these two commodities, these are similar goods. If I raise the price of Lux, people will go to buy care. That is true. So these are similar. These are the substitutes. But these are not same. If the commodities are same, for example, Lux, everybody is producing the same thing. Then the commodity becomes homogeneous. Homogeneous means identical. Identical, same. There is no difference. If it is Nadishal Chal or rice, so everybody is producing the same thing, everybody is selling the same thing. So this is homogeneous. And if you go for some packaging and he is selling the product, he is not going for any packaging, even then these are not same. Because when you package something, you are making some difference.
Colors.
So you are making the product heterogeneous, not homogeneous, differentiated. So that the people will go to you.
But inside material same.
It's the same, but the people will go to him because of this packaging, because of his behavior maybe. So you can make a same product differentiated by providing some advertisement, some kind of promotional activity, some packaging, etc. The same product, you can make it different.
Mom like this, sir.
Hmm?
Mom.
Yeah, mom and?
Sir, bottle er karone ora je sell kore pura Bangladesh
e yes.
Pani gulo oto sell korte
hobe. Yeah, the water used by mom and for example washer. The water is same.
But
rather bottle design karone ora.
See, you see, for the packaging, for the bottling, or for this kind of promotional activity, you see, so homogeneous means there is no difference, no difference anyway. Okay, so product is homogeneous and number of buyers, say it is large. Large means what? Number of sellers, say large. So what does it mean? How will you identify the number? It is large means what? It is 50, 200, 500?
Compared to other.
Yes, what is the scale? So scale is here. Control over price. The number will be large. The buyers will be large if any of the buyers cannot make the price. So they are the price takers. So what does it mean? Price taking, price making. A buyer is a price taker. What does it mean?
Buyer.
Is a price taker. Price taker means what? I am accepting the price. I don't have any influence over the price. I cannot make it. That means if in the market the price is 50, I have agreed. Supposed to buy. Yeah, I agree to buy. Because I don't have any capacity to make it to 48 or 36 or 40. So that is called price taking. So I am the price taker. So buyer is the price taker. Large means no buyer got any influence on the price. All are price takers. Okay. And sellers are also large. That means what? They are also price takers. So it doesn't mean they are the price takers. It doesn't mean that the number is 50 will not be less. It doesn't mean that. So if you have 50 buyers and everybody is supposed to take the price, then it is less. So you cannot tell that 100 will be less, 120 will be less, 500 will be less. So theoretically you can tell it. So what you have to say, see or check whether the buyer can influence the price or not. If the buyers are taking the price, fine, they are less. Number is less. The number of buyers is less. Sellers, if every seller is supposed to or has to sell their product at a fixed price. I mean the price which is established in the market. They cannot make any price.
Accepted price.
So that will be less. So how will I identify whether the number of buyers is large or not? Check the control over the price. Whether they can control the price or not. Controlling means they can make the price. If they want to make the price, for example, 22, if the price is now, for example, you want to give 20, but they are asking 22. And eventually if you are bound to buy the product at 22 or pay 22, that means the buyer, seller is making the price. Seller got the control of the price. If seller anyway can control the price, can make the price, control means price making, then the number is less. It is not that much kind of numerical number. It's numerical number, but you can say it's 50, 70, 200. No. You have to look at this, whether they can make the price or not. If they are price takers, so for example, up to if the number is 50 and all are price takers, fine.
Large scale.
So these are the definition of layers. Okay, so large number of buyers, large number of sellers, nature of the commodity homogeneous, and they are the price, both the price takers. And then you can add another column, the availability of substitutes. Availability of substitutes. So since these are homogeneous product, actually usually you don't have to think about the substitutes, because these are homogeneous product, totally homogeneous. These are not differentiated, so you don't need to care this. And then since the number is large, another thing happens, the exit entry of firms into industry. What does it mean? What do you mean by firm? And what is industry? Firm means a production unit. For example, in garment industry, you have a lot of plants, garment factories. Every factory call is called as firm.
Industrial total system.
Total, yeah. So, collection of firms.
Yeah.
So, maybe it is for garments. What type of factories are there?
Apparel industry.
That's textile, yeah. Knitting.
Knitting. All these factories, all types of factories which are related to garment production.
Industry.
Butter industry.
Industry. Yeah. So, industry doesn't mean that, for example, soup industry doesn't mean that only you are considering the bars, soap bars. The powder, liquid, all the soap type items.
Detergent.
Will be included in the industry. So all the firms which are producing the similar product or same product, doesn't matter. So these will be the industry. Exit and entry means, in this situation, since the number is large, the exit entry is free. Because nobody is carrying others. For example, you are producing something. Already 100 people, 200 people are producing one thing. And if he enters into the industry, because he started to produce the same thing, maybe you will not care that. You will not care that, because you already have 500, 400, 200 people in the industry, 200 farms in the industry. So for example, you think of farmers. So we have 1,000 farmers, they are producing paddy. So another person, he is producing, he was supposed to produce, for example, potato. Now he started to produce paddy. You produce paddy. Now he joined in that kind of production process, like he started to produce paddy. So what will happen? Will you care this or not? Because in an industry, if you have a lot of farms, nobody cares. For example, if you have a shop, tea stall here, only one tea stall, if you find another tea stall is coming to join there, what will happen? That tea stall owner will not allow that person to do this business. Why? Because he will not tolerate it. He will think that his business will be hampered, his profit will be reduced, or his sales will
share
be...
Share
yeah, market will be
shared.
But think of Nilkent or TSC. It doesn't matter how many sellers are there.
Okay.
Doesn't matter, because a lot of people are there, a lot of customers are there. So they don't care. But here, they think that the Bangladesh Open University students are fixed. So they are given. And in the evening, if we have to share these customers, so maybe my revenue will fall. So, if you have large numbers, you don't care actually who is entering into the farm industry and which farm is going on. You don't care. Because huge number of sellers are there, farms are there. So, you don't care who is entering, who is exiting, or who is going outside the industry, who is leaving the industry. So if this is the situation, and another characteristic we can add is the knowledge. So knowledge about the market. knowledge about the market. In this situation, we assume that everybody, all the buyers, all the sellers got perfect knowledge about the market. So for example, if you ask 12 taka for a product, usually it should be 10 taka. If you ask 12 taka, so I know some other people, lot of other people, they are selling the same product at 10 taka. So I will not buy from you because I have the knowledge about the market. And if a buyer wants to give a lower price for a product, so you know there are a lot of buyers in the market and you know other sellers, everybody is selling the product at this price. So if the buyer goes there, he or she must buy the product at this price. So if you have the knowledge about the market, clear knowledge.
Information.
Knowledge means information. So clear information or knowledge about the market, what will happen? So you have a perfect knowledge or information about the market. This is perfect. So there is nothing to hide from the buyers or from the sellers. If this is the situation, nobody can make the price and anybody can enter, anybody can exit. If this is the situation, this market structure is highly competitive. So we call it perfectly. Perfect competition. So this is the market structure. So this market structure. This market structure is called. No, this is in the beginning. So if you have these situations, you have large number of buyers, that means nobody can make the price. Large number of sellers, nobody can make the price. Everybody is price taker. Nature of the commodity is homogeneous, same product. There is no differentiation. There is no difference between his product and my product. And exit entry of the farms, free. Anybody can enter, anybody can exit, easily. And knowledge about the market is perfect. This market structure is called perfect competition. So if you are asked to explain or describe the characteristics of
perfect.
A perfectly competitive market structure, so what do you say? The number of buyers large, the number of sellers large, nature of the commodity homogeneous, both are price takers, and exit entry of the firm is free. Also, the knowledge about the market is perfect.
But what about the availability of substitutes?
Because you are talking about homogeneous.
Sure.
These are same. These are not differentiated. So that's why we just put this column.
No substitute.
We are putting this column because it may have some substitutes. These are remote substitutes. There is no closed substitute here. And since it's homogeneous, we don't consider this. It is not a matter in this case. Okay. Now, think of another situation. Make it one, only one seller. So, what will be the as homogeneous? Okay.
Homogeneous.
Homogeneous means only one seller, only one product. So, this is same. Nature is same.
Homogeneous means the
what the product he is producing, only one. So that's why it's in one sense it's homogeneous. Because it's only one product, only one seller, so in that sense it's homogeneous. But here the thing is, there is no no closed substitutes. Because since he is the only one seller, so there is no closed substitutes. Closed substitutes. We have to ensure this. In this case, you may have some substitutes. Since the number is large and that nobody is price takers.
Insignificant.
Yeah, insignificant. But here it is very important, crucial. Only one seller is there. So it is, you have to ensure that there is no close up. Otherwise, this person will not be able to control the price perfectly. So in this case, the seller is price maker. What happens to the buyers. Suppose the buyers are large.
So no
price. Price? Taker. So buyers are price takers and sellers are price makers. There is no closed substitute.
No competition.
What about this exit entry? No.
No.
nobody will be allowed to enter into the industry. They will try to use all the means, maybe law, trust, anything. They will try to use all the means to stop someone else to enter into the industry. They will use the government machinery, etc. Never, not perfect, because only this person knows about this. Other people know. So what is the knowledge about this person? Because if these persons know about these things, how they will know? Because all the secrets belong to this only one seller. If I don't inform you, how you know it? So that's why it is not perfect. Knowledge is not perfect. Okay. In this situation, you see, the product is homogeneous, fine. The most important thing is there is no closed substitute. You can have substitute. You will not find anything on this earth which doesn't have any substitute. Everything got the substitute. One is remote substitute, another is closed substitute. So, for example, bus, train, these are closed substitutes, in one sense. But if you think of bus and plane, these are not closed. And sometimes it depends on a lot of other things. For example, if all the people are rich,
international flight,
yes, maybe, yeah, yes, so it is not a
domestic flight, but international flight,
yes, for some people maybe train and bus are substitutes.
In Europe, train and plane are almost
same. Japan, Europe, yeah, same. Domestic plane and train is same. These are very close substitutes. Yeah. The price, factor, everything same. So you have to ensure that this kind of market structure, in this kind of market structure, you don't have any close substitutes. So this is one. One means mono.
Monopoly.
One means mono. Buyer or seller.
What is that?
One buyer or seller.
One
seller. Seller means poly. These are not English words. You have to remember, monopoly is not an English word. So in English, lot of other words came in.
Poly only, then our mono will be poly.
Poly means seller.
Normally, one. Can you see that?
Yes, seller. Seller.
Mono
means one.
Yes,
English meaning is one. And poly, English meaning of poly is seller. Economically, is a market structure where you have only one seller. And there is no process. So if you say monopoly means only one seller, it's not true. You have to say also it doesn't have any closed substitutes. Yeah, so it was monopoly. What about the railway? Railway is monopoly, what do you think?
Bangladesh, our country respect
monopoly.
Railway is monopoly?
So
think of it. Number of providers, one. But it got closed substitute, so that's why it is not monopoly. Bus is not monopoly. So, if you like to say something is, any farm is a monopolist, you must consider this. This is very important. If you see that the product got closed substitutes, then it's not monopoly. Okay, so monopoly. Second market structure. So, if you are asked to explain the characteristics of a monopoly or monopolist farm, what do you say? Large number of buyers,
but
one seller, homogeneous, buyers are takers, price takers, and sellers are price makers. There is no closed substitutes, no executive of the firms, and
no perfect knowledge.
Yes.
Sir,
it is
no closed substitute link
or no closed substitute? No, no closed, sorry. No closed substitutes. Thank you. No closed substitutes. Okay, then make it few, less, homogeneous. It can be heterogeneous too. So for simplicity, we are considering this homogeneous. Okay, it can be homogeneous in both. So for simplicity, we are assuming that it is only homogeneous. Okay, few, less, homogeneous. Now, what about the buyers? They are price takers or
few price
takers.
Seller
buyers.
Seller few.
Buyers to large. Takers.
Buyers are price takers. So we are putting price takers.
Can you, sir?
Yeah, because these are the buyers. Buyers.
Oh, buyers.
So this is for buyers.
Oh,
the upper portion is for buyers and the lower portion will be for sellers. So sellers are few. Price takers or makers?
Takers.
Why price maker? Because they don't have because it is not large. Any number other than large so indicate that
the dominant to the order.
This people cannot dominate like these people. So it's only one person. You have few, more than one.
Right, sir.
So it is not true that the power, monopoly power of this person and monopoly power of these persons will be same. It will never be same because it is not only one.
Okay.
So few means it can be 2, it can be 3, it can be 20.
More than one.
Yeah, more than one. Okay, so substitutes. Okay, so you don't need to think of substitutes because it can be homogeneous or heterogeneous. So if it is heterogeneous, you have substitutes. If it's homogeneous, we are ignoring substitute because it's not important here.
Jokhon seller one. তখন সে প্রাইস পে করতে পারে
যখন
সে ফিউ তখন ওই প্রাইস পে করতে
পারে ইয়েস প্রাইস দে ইস ইয়েস দ্য সেলার বিকজ ফিউ সেলারস দে ক্যান মেক প্রাইস বিকজ ইট নট লার্জ হাউ দে ক্যান মেক প্রাইস
সিন্ডিকেট
ইজ ডিফারেন্ট থিং ইয়েস উই উইল কাম টু দ্য পয়েন্ট বাট ইভেন ইফ ইউ ডোন্ট হ্যাভ এনি সিন্ডিকেট ইউ ক্যান মেক প্রাইস বিকজ ইউ হ্যাভ ফিউ সেলারস ইন দ্য মার্কেট সো দে ক্যান মেক প্রাইস Because it is not less. Few means it is less than less. So you can make price. Later we'll see how they make the price. Okay. Exit and enter restricted. Since few, there will be a tendency for them to
register to
be colluded. So they will always try to be united. And what is the reason? We'll talk about that. So that's why it is restricted. They will not allow a new firm to enter. They will collectively face it. So we'll see that how they do it. And not perfect apparently. Not perfect. Because if you go beyond the perfect competition, all are imperfect competition. All are the imperfect competitions. So you have perfect competition, all these are imperfect. So whatever we are talking now, all are imperfect. So in imperfect, you can make price anyhow. Here the highest power you have, here the maybe little low, and then lowest. So it doesn't matter. You can make price. So in this case, few means only this. Still it's not an English word. It's more probably Greek. Only this. And seller or buyer. Seller or buyer?
Sellers.
So that's why we call it oligopoly. So usually we erase this. So it is oligopoly. This is the oligopoly market structure. Oligopoly means you have large number of buyers but few numbers of sellers. Homogeneous or heterogeneous. It can be heterogeneous too.
So poly means seller.
Yeah, poly means seller. So price taker, maker, restricted, etc.
Sir, so, why restricted?
Restricted means, okay, so suppose few, they are few. Okay? So if you have few numbers of sellers in the world or in the market for 5, 10, 20, what will happen? I can give you one example. In Chakpur launch cart, what happened? The launches were going to Borishal. So one launch owner, they declared a lower price, lower fare on that day. And what happened? Another one followed that. They reduced a little bit more. And eventually what happened? Everybody were taking the passengers without any fare. Without any fare. What happened?
Free.
It was totally free and then they offered lunch, etc., etc. So the whole day it happened. So what is this? This is called price war. Price war. Since you have few people, if you are engaged in a competition, what competition? competition you will do? Just will reduce the price, nothing else. So if I compete with you, only two people are selling the product. For example, you are producing oil, petroleum, I am producing the petroleum. So if you sell the petroleum, because the market is fixed. So if you sell the petroleum at, for example, 80 taka per barrel, or I don't know, $80 per barrel. What I will do? I will reduce it, for example, $70 per barrel. Then you will sell it $60 per barrel. So the competition is all about the price. Nothing else. So what will happen? Everybody will be loser. Because you have a huge market, only few sellers. So that's why they always try to avoid this price war. They don't like to have this price war. In that launch guard, they sit together and they
decide.
Decided that we will not go for this kind of price war. Okay, this is one thing. So what happens to avoid this price wars? You go for some collusions. What is collusion? No, collusion, you means you are united. So when you call Sangharsha, that means I. Collision, that's collision. So we are using you, that means people are, these firms are colluded. They are they form the association or they call it. So it can be of two types. One can be written. Written collusion, another is can be unwritten. What is written collusion?
Agreements.
So for example, we three people are selling the product. What we can do? We can sit together. We can decide, this is our market. So you have bigger reserve. I have the second best reserve, and he is the lowest reserve. So let us try to decide what will be our supply all over the market, all over the world. Okay, so this is the market. We'll supply this amount, and you will produce this, I will produce this, and you will produce this, and the price will be this. So that means it's a written agreement. So which is called cartel. Yes, this is called cartel. Cartel means written agreement. So one example can be OPEC. OPEC, you know?
Yes, sir.
Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries. So in OPEC, what they do? All the foreign ministers of, or oil ministers of the oil producing countries, they come together, they sit, they decide what will be their supply all over the world. During this time. Then they divide the portions. You will produce that, you will produce that. The Saudi cannot decide what amount of petroleum they will export. They cannot decide.
OPEC.
This is the OPEC. They decide. So all over the world, we will export or we will sell this amount of the petroleum. And Saudi will produce that. And you will produce that, you will produce that. You cannot exit.
ছোট ধরনের
And you have some unwritten. Unwritten means leader follower.
Restaurant.
Yes, in some cases they got the written agreement. So it is a kind of oligopolistic. If the sellers are colluded in any form, that is an oligopolistic nature. Can be association, can be anything else. And this collusion can be unwritten too. Unwritten means like I am producing the things at a very lowest cost. For example, my per unit cost is 10 taka. And he is another producer. His per unit cost is 15 taka. Now, what he will do? And I got the, since I am producing at low cost, so what will happen?
Price will be.
You will follow me.
Right.
You will follow me because if he wants to play with me, he will not be able to play because my production cost is very low. So that's why this is a kind of leader-follower model. So leader-follower coalition. This coalition is unwritten, but this person will automatically follow me. If he wants to sell the product at 9 taka, he will be out from the market. So I will not allow him to sell the product at 9 taka because his cost is 15. For any reason he wants to play in the market with me, that means he is asking a lower price. So I will not allow him. Maybe I will just down the price, maybe 5 taka, and he will be out. Then I will
increase my rate.
Yeah, I will increase my benefits, profit or price. So these are the things. In unwritten way, also the people are colluded. He is following me. This is one thing. Another thing is, I am sharing, I got or I hold the maximum share of the market. The market is in my control. So he is a small firm. See, if he comes, he will follow me. If you think that in a area, you have a big Mustang, so new Mustang will follow that person because he got the control over this area. So if you like to play with him, so maybe you will be out from the scenario. So in the market, if you have the largest share of the market, you got the control. So other people, the small firms, they will follow. This is one thing. Another thing is, if I am the low-cost producer, so everybody must follow me. Automatically. So it is not necessary that you have to have written agreement. They will naturally follow me.
For their existence.
For their existence. Otherwise they will not be able to exist. Okay. So these are the things. So Kaitan, if you are asked to give an example, you can mention Upen. Another Kaitan is called D. Beers. D. Beers is a diamond Kaitan. You know Beers brothers, the British farmer who got diamond in South Africa first. His name is some Beers. And his sons, Beers are his sons actually. So when he got two sons, so that farm has been, that business has been divided into two. So then they thought that if they are engaged in a competition, the price of diamond will be much lower. So to hold the price of diamond up, They have been colluded. So that is another card. That is written. That is another card. So this is called DBS, another card. You will not find that much written cartels, written collisions. This is not usually happen because cartel is not an easy thing. See, if one party got some vested interest, they will try to break it. Like Iraq, Saddam wanted to do it. And that's why he got the main problem with Kuwait. Because Kuwait got huge reserve and got a dominance over OPEC. So what happened? When Saddam wanted to explore more and sell more, and they wanted the support from Kuwait, Kuwait didn't give the support. Also Kuwait, Saddam had he borrowed a lot of money from Kuwait during the war. So that's why he wanted to explore more and more oil. And he wanted to return that money. And he asked them to support. When the Kuwait didn't support, so they thought that, yeah, this is the best way to occupy the territory. So these are the oligopolistic nature. In oligopoly, you usually face the price war.
And to avoid the price war.
To avoid the price war, they go for the collisions. Either in written form or non-written. So, in oligopoly, you may have two firms. If you have two firms, two means do. Do, it's a French word. D-U-O. So, it can be duopoly. Duopoly. Okay. And it can be triopoly. So you see, it can be simply oligopoly. This is also oligopoly. This is also oligopoly. It doesn't matter. You can call it oligopoly. Specifically, you can call it duopoly if the number is 2. 3, you can call it triopoly. These are the
difference. Yeah, something like this is common.
Pardon?
Duopoly, triopoly, you know, the common market.
No? Yes. Open
yeah. Yeah. Second,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's very difficult. It's possible. Okay, then make it large, fine, and many. So products are now heterogeneous. Because you cannot find many people, so if the number is many, it is not large yet. Okay? So think of the control of our price. So there are the price takers and there are the price
makers.
So this is the price making for these people and for these people and for these people are not same. These firms still they make the price, but they are the weakest one. Because this is the strongest. So one person they can make price. A or C can make price. So in this situation, you have yes, lot of substitutes. Lot of substitutes because it is citizens. And somewhat restricted and not perfect.
Sir, it's still restriction.
Yeah, restricted because it is many, not large. So if it is not large, it is not free. It is not free. So what happens? So if you have many sellers and heterogeneous, that means what?
Competition.
You have the products, but all the products are not same. Similar. For example, you are Unilever, you are producing glass. You are Kohinoor, you are producing Tibet. Kia Cosmetics, they are producing Kia. So glass, Tibet, Kia, three producers. So you are deciding everything about Lux. So you got the monopoly over that. You are the only producer of Lux. And he is the only producer of Tibet. And he is the only producer of
Kia.
So what happens? You have three monopolists. But here you didn't have close substitutes. You have the substitutes. So Lux, Tibet and Kia, these are substitutes. If you just increase a little bit the price, so these people will react. So in this situation, you will find huge competition among the producers, sellers, among the sellers or producers. They got huge competition because the products are very close.
Yes.
Substitutes. They got a substitute. So you have monopoly power. Why? The Lever brothers can increase the price a little bit. Why? How? Because some people, because they got the brand image, some people are attached to us. So they can raise one taka. They will not leave. But you have some people, they can easily leave. That the people who are using Pocha Shaban for washing their hair. So what will happen? It doesn't matter, the brand doesn't matter to them. So they can switch
price
immediately to other
price
people. Because you see, the what is the percentage of the people who are not caring the brand image or brand
quality.
Yeah, quality, etc.
So
what is the percentage? Smaller amount?
No, large.
It is at least 60%, 70%. In Bangladesh, you will find almost 70% plus people, they don't care this brand. Because how many people are living outside the cities? So they don't care. So in that case, you see, if you want to increase the price, you will not be that much successful. But you have got the capability. Because you are the only producer of glass. So you can ask higher price. And what is the power? Power is, you know some people are at a street. So since you know some people are at a street, so if I can increase a little bit, they will not leave to another product. So that is the thing. So you have monopoly power, but it is not like that. You have competition. So that's why this market structure is called monopolistic competition. Because you have. So now, someone is talking about, I think, telecommunication. You have four, five, six providers. So is it oligopoly or monopolistic competition? What do you think?
Monopoly.
It's not monopoly because you have six providers. And oligopoly? No oligopoly because they are not colluded. They are competing each other. So it is monopolistic competition. The sweets. So all the sweet producers, they are the competitors. So monopolistic competition. So that's why monopolistic, you will find most of the markets are monopolistically competitive market structures. And then, if you think of one, only one buyer, only one seller. For example, it is homogeneous. So both are price? No, makers. You have one here. Both are price? Makers. And you can think of, oh yeah, since homogeneous, maybe it can restrict it. So in this market structure, what is the name of this market structure? You have what? You have monopoly here and here
monopoly.
Single seller. Here single seller and single buyer. So this is called bilateral monopoly. You have one buyer, one seller. You can find some farms. So they are producing only one thing. Other people are not producing the same thing. And the buyer is only one. For example, if someone is producing, for example, wagon, railway wagon, who will buy it? Government. So only one buyer and one seller. It is possible. And you may have some other market structure. Like one here, large here, that's homogeneous. So one buyer, isn't it?
Yes.
One buyer. So maker, price maker and taker. And go, just other things you can put.
Okay,
so you can put it. So one buyer, large sellers. One buyer, mono. Mono what? One is mono. Buyer or seller?
Buyer.
Buyer. It's not poly.
Okay.
It is Sony. Sony means P-S-O-N-Y. Sony means buyer.
Japanese.
Huh? No, these are not Japanese. These are Latin or Greek. So this is Latin. Yeah. So these are not English words. So no one is English words. So monopolistic is fine. Yeah, this came from monopoly. This is not English word. 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 So mono Sony. P-S-O-N-O. Sony means buyer. So mono Sony means only one buyer in the market. You can find some situation where only one buyer is there. For example, anything you produce relating to railway, so the government will be the buyer, only buyer. So sometimes, for example, electricity, who is the buying the electricity? From the quick rentals, from everybody, government is buying. The distributor is only government. So government is buying from everybody. This is kind of monopsony scenario. So now, for example, the Boilers Association. So what is the nature? What kind of market structure it is? Boilers Association or market syndication. We sometimes call market syndication. The people, sellers are syndicated. They are colluded each other. So what kind of market structure that is? What kind of behavior?
Oligopolistic
behavior. See, in oligopoly, you will find the people are colluded. In any form, written or unwritten, they are colluded. If you find any association or they are working together, it is an oligopolistic behavior. Most important thing is thing for oligopoly is, if you form cartel, if you just go for a legal agreement, legal collusion, written collusion, written collusion, written means legal, written collusion means you are deciding by sitting
together.
Sitting at a single place. So you are deciding only one price. So you are thinking of the supply of the product all over the world or all over the market. So So they first decide, define the what? Decide the amount you will produce and the price. Then it is divided. What is divided? The price, not the price, but the quantity, the share.
Price.
So you will sell this, you will sell this, you will sell this. So what happens actually? It is kind of monopolist behavior. Because when you form this cartel, what happens? Saudi Arabia or Kuwait or Iran, nobody can decide by themselves. Everything is decided at OPEC.
No problem.
They decide there what will be their supply, total supply in the world, and what will be the price. That's all. So oligopolies, if they are colluded or they are catalyzed, if they go for written collusion or if they form cartel, they become monopolist. So that is a strong tendency that the oligopolists, they together become or behave like a
monopolist.
So these are all about market structures. So in next class what we will do, we will see how a firm decides what will be the level of output the firm will produce. How they decide? We said they will consider the cost and we said they will consider the revenue. Now we can easily understand the price of the product of the firm. Because the firm will look at the market structure, then they will get an idea about the price. So in next class we will try to see how the firm reaches its equilibrium. So what do you have to know? If I ask you to explain how a firm reaches its equilibrium, so what you have to know? You have to know the type of the firm. So the product of the firm goes to what kind of market structure? What kind of firm it is? It is a perfectly competitive market firm, or it is a monopolist firm, or it is an oligopolist firm, or it is a monopolistically competitive firm, or it is a monopsonist, bilateral, yeah. So what market structure the firm belong to? Then we will come to the decision. How they decide. Okay? Thank you very much.
শনিবার
শনিবার পুরি নেবেন না?